Hey everyone, welcome back. So in the last video, we saw how we just kicked off the script and we made communication with the Appium server as well as the Android emulator. So in this video, what we're going to do is just simply add a new contact, and we're just going to do this via caption element IDs and XPath. So what we're going to do is pretty much we're going to click on this add new contact button, and then you're going to get this prompt. What you want to do is just simply hit cancel, and then once we get on this page, what we're going to do is just enter our first name, last name, and phone number, and then simply save. So let's hop into it. Let's start the session. All right, so let's start capturing some of our elements that we're going to need to interact with. So the first one is going to be the floating button. So this is this resource, and we can use define by ID or XPath, and we have the two selectors, the values we can use for that. I'm going to be using the ID. The XPath is very long. You can use them both, but when it comes to readability, it's way too long. So we're just going to stick to the nice and easy ID. And XPaths are not really reliable. If something were to move, object move, things could shift that object, and then the XPath could be like broken. So having a safe and reliable ID is always good practice. So first thing we're going to do is let's call this button. So we're going to call this web element. We're going to call this add contact button is equal to driver dot find element, and we can do by any of these. So we have by, this is going to use the Selenium library. We can also use any of these CSS, custom ID, image link name. What we're going to be using is ID, and we're going to paste that ID. So go to your inspector, you're going to copy command C, and we're going to paste that right there, add your semicolon to the end, and make sure you import this Selenium web element. All right, so now that's there, what we want to do is just simply click. So we're going to copy the button, and you can do dot, there's a click action, so you just hit dot click and it's going to click it. All right, always good to add comments. So what I'm going to do is add a comment and just call this add a new contact button. All right, so now we can do a quick test to make sure that that's happening. So you can do run as a Java application, and remember, since I ran it as a Java application, I can no longer just refresh it. That session no longer registers with the inspector. So you just have to click the quit session and then start it back up. So I'm just gonna go step by step. All right, so now what we need to do is capture this cancel button. So now we're gonna do is just hit refresh on the inspector. We can see this element as well as any of these elements is here. So we have the cancel button, so let's put that here. We can copy this and paste it as well. And let's call this button click cancel button. So now we're telling it to click the cancel button. So what we're going to do is change the name, the cancel button, and cancel button dot click. Also, what's a good practice is every time that you click a button that makes you switch to another screen, you should add some type of wait or make sure the element is available before you try to interact with it. So add some waits. And what type of waits I like to use? I like to use this wait called a web driver wait. So that's what we're going to set up. And we normally can set this up at the top right after my driver. So I can set, so I'm just gonna type web driver weight. I'm just calling it weight equal new web driver weight. And what we need to add, what we need to add is the driver and the time. So let's do 20 seconds. So web driver weight equal new web driver weight, and let's close that up. Import, just clean up my syntax, sorry about that. There we go. So now we have our weight element. So what we're going to do is say after we click the add contact button, wait for either this text or this cancel button to display before you try to click it. So in order to do that, we're just going to say wait. We're going to put it right here, wait until, and there's a function, and the function is called expected condition dot presence of element by locator, and in this case by, we're going to say ID. So we're just going to grab, let's grab the ID of the cancel button. So just simply copy that, and we're going to paste that ID, and we're going to add our semicolon, which is nice. So add the contact button, we're going to add some weight. So wait until the cancel button displays. Once it's displays, we're going to initialize or set that variable, and then we're going to click on it. Looks good so far. All right, next we want to do is once we click this, so let's click that button. Good, and let's refresh. Perfect. So now we're just going to copy these objects, these elements, and we're going to interact with them. Enter our first name, last name, phone number, click the save button, and we're done. So what I'm going to do is just copy this a couple times. Well, copy this once. So now we're going to say click and enter data for first name. Okay, so we're going to call this first name, and I like to tell it what type of elements are edit box. All right, make sure to take out this old element, and we're going to do a search. So in this case, it seems that we have to use the XPath, which is a good example to use. So what we have to do is just copy this long string, Command C, and instead of by ID, we can do X path, and then we paste. Long XPath. So now we have our element set. So click and enter data on the first name. So what we did is just going to click on it, and now we have to enter data. In order to enter data, you're going to do send keys, and the send keys in this case, I'm just going to say J. Jamal's already taken. I'm just going to copy this because we're going to use the same thing for the last name. So let's call this last name edit box, copy that, same thing, click and then send. We're gonna say last name Rich, and let's take this long and I think this case it's just a 2, so it's the same thing, but in this case it's 2. So let's enter the 2, click save. So now we're going to enter first name, last name, and the last thing we have to do is a phone number. So let's Oh man, I hate those expats, they're so long. But let's copy that one more time and bring it in. All right, so we're just gonna call this phone num edit box and change everything here. So phone num edit box, and just remove this long expat. I don't think this one is like a three. It's grouped differently, so let's see. All right, so if I'm here, now we can see it's definitely different, no three. So copy and just paste. All right, so I'm done. So all we have now is to click the save button. In this case, what's the number? The number is going to be 12345559876. Give me a call. All right, so change the comment from these first names. I'm clicking enter data for phone number and enter data for last name. And last but not least is to click on the save button. So I'm just copying and pasting. You're going to do a lot of that when you're developing. And this is going to be save button, copy, paste, click. And to get the save button over, nice, this one has an ID, perfect. Copy, find element by ID, expat, expat, expat. Okay, good. And this one is the ID, paste, and click save. So far, let's see what we have. So we have click add to contact, add a new contact button. We add a wait because we changed to that page. We click the cancel button, so we should add a wait because we switched to another page. So copy this. And what element can we find? Let's see, let's see what I can use. Something that has, yeah, let's say account name. So we're gonna go back and where's my wait? Right here. Okay, so now we're gonna wait for that to appear. Once that appears, we're gonna click first name, enter J, click last name, enter Rich, enter phone number. We're gonna click the save button. And let's see what happens after that. This is a good time to run a test. And just click run Java application. Nice. So we see we have a error. It didn't like something, could not locate an error. So let's see what it didn't like. So I'm saying click, add some weights, wait for the left button. I'm telling it to click on the float. Oh, yep, that's not good. Need to click the cancel button. See, this is what happens when you copy and paste. Stuff like that happens. But as long as you know how to fix it, it's good. So let's clear this and let's retest that. There we go. So now it's entering J, entering Rich, enter in the phone number, and wow, and it's saved. JRich save. Boom, test complete. So that's a quick way how you can get started with Appium inside of Java and writing a quick script. Sometimes, as you can see, that the keyboard was propped. Sometimes you may not want to have the keyboard open while you're running your test. So there's a way we can avoid that. So I'm just going to add that quick capability to this so you can see. So let's say hide keyboard. Show you how it is when it's hidden. So all we gotta do is pretty much copy like this type of setup. And what I need to type is, we're going to type is Unicode keyboard. So Unicode keyboard. and this is going to be true. We can copy this because we have to do one more, and this one is going to be called reset keyboard. And that's going to be true. Alright, so make sure you don't have that contact saved still. It is saved, so let's just delete that. Else it's going to interfere with the script. You don't have no logic to handle anything that pops up unexpectedly, so just going to remove that, and we're going to run a test to show you how it looks without the keyboard. So now you can see it's just running JRidge phone number, no keyboard popping up, and it's saved, working flawlessly, just as we expected. So now that's pretty much it. The last thing I wanted to show you is just gonna hit this back button, how you navigate using some of the native buttons. Head back, you're gonna see two of the items in the list. And then I'm just going to use the quit so the web driver can be closed and terminated successfully. And that will wrap up the script. That will wrap up our testing. So let's just delete using JUnit as your test tool. Right now we're just using simple Java, but if I were to, let's say, remove static, because JUnit don't like static, and I add the annotation.test. I click save. Let's import that test from JUnit. Go into your main void, make sure that's commented out, because it's just going to run directly from the test. And if everything goes well, we should see JUnit test. And we have Appium test here running, so that's pretty good. And if it failed, you're going to see a big red failure. If it passed, you're going to see a green. And here we could just add different like assertions. So if something were to be true, we can write, you know, Jahmal, a first name, enter, true. You know, if that was able to get to that element and able to send text, you can write assert true, assert false, any type of other logic. But I can show you guys more details about JUnit and testing with JUnit and different assertions. But in this video, I just wanted to make sure you can get started with your first Appium script and having all the tools you need. If this video definitely was helpful, please smash that like button. Continue to show support. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in another video. If you have any questions or have any issues, please feel free to drop them in the comments. And I'll see you in another video. Good night.